Let's begin to explore tool palettes from top to bottom. The first one is the Move tool. The Move tool allows you to move layers and selected areas. To move a layer, first of all, make sure that that layer is active in the layer palette. To activate the layer, simply click on it. It will get highlighted, indicating that the layer is active. Then click on the layer and drag it to the desired location. To move a selection, once again, make sure that the layer where you want to select the area is active. Make a selection. Go back to Move tool. Click and drag to the desired location. In addition to moving layers and selected areas around, Move tool is also used to copy, like your selected areas. Make sure a layer is active. You have your selection. Hold Option key. Click and drag to the desired location. To duplicate a layer, once again, make sure that that layer is active. Hold Option key. Click and duplicate. You could see that in the layer palette, I have three layers now. Layer 0 copy, and my text layer. Let's delete the newly created one. In addition to copying selected areas and layers within one document, you can use Move tool to copy things into a new document. To copy a layer into a new document, click on the layer and drag it into the new document. To copy selection, select the area, go back to Move tool, click and drag into a new document. You could see that no changes happened in my original document, and all new copies in the new document showed up as the new layers. Below the Move tool are a number of selection tools. Selection tools are very important in the Adobe Photoshop. You will use them for basic actions like cut, copy, and clear. To fill the parts of your document with patterns or color. And do any kind of editing to the part of your document without affecting the rest of your artwork. In addition, you will use selections to transform parts of your layer. And separate elements of your artwork into different layers. The first set of selections are marquee tools. Rectangular marquee is the most popular one. I use it to create stripes and plaids, to define specific repeats, and define patterns from the part of my image. To use rectangular marquee tool, simply click and drag around the area you want to select. To create a square, click, hold Shift key, and drag around the area you want to select. You can also move your selection by rolling cursor over to the selected area, click and drag to the desired location. All the tools in the tool palette have their own options conveniently displayed in the option bar. For example, all the selection tools have a number of commands, like New Selection. That simply allows you to create a new selection. Add to the selection. And subtract from the selection. You can also add and subtract from the selection using your keyboard. Hold Shift key to add to the selection. And hold Option key to subtract. Marquee tools have their own styles. We worked in normal style, but you can also choose fixed ratio. Right now it's 1:1. So any selection I create will be a perfect square. I can set my own ratios. For example, golden ratio. So any selections that I'm going to create now, no matter where I drag my cursor, will maintain these perfect proportions. And the final one is fixed size. For example, I want all my selections to be 3 by 5 inches. Now all I have to do is a click on my document and the fixed size selection will show up. And don't forget to go back to normal style. The next set is Lasso Tools. Lasso Tool allows you to create a freehand selection of an image. To make a selection, click and drag the mouse around the desired area and release to complete the selection. Polygon Lasso Tool creates polygon shape selections. It works by setting anchor points and connecting them with the straight line. I prefer Polygon Tool because it allows me to create precise selections. Click and release the mouse in the area you want to start the selection. Click again to set the second anchor point and continue along the lines by clicking and releasing the mouse. You can see that Photoshop creates the straight lines to connect your anchor points. To finish the selection, make sure you close it. Roll your cursor over to the starting point, and when the circle shows up near your cursor, that means the selection is ready to be closed. Click and release to close the selection. Make sure the correct layer is selected. Magnetic Lasso Tool works by recognizing colors and contrast. It creates selections by snapping to points around the edges of the area being traced. To use it, click and release the mouse to start the selection. Then move your cursor around the desired area. Lasso will automatically snap in places along the way, creating anchor points as you trace. Click and release to set your own anchor points, just like with Polygon Lasso. And click and release to close the selection. Let's subtract this little purple area. Holding Option key, start the process again. Click and release to start the selection. Click and release to close. So far, we've covered the tools that create selections based on shapes. There are other options to create selections. For example, Quick Selection Tool. It allows you to create a selection by painting the desired area using an adjustable round tip brush. To use this tool, click and drag over the area you want to paint with your selection. If you release the mouse, the tool will go into Add to the Selection mode. That will allow you seamlessly to paint with your selection. And you can always go to Subtract from the Selection mode to delete undesired selected areas. And the final option allows you to create the selection based on color. Magic Wand selects areas of similar hues, saturation, and lightness. Tolerance of each can be adjusted in the option bar. The smaller the tolerance, the fewer of similar colors will be selected. The larger the tolerance, the more of similar color will be selected. Hold Shift key to add to the selection and Option key to subtract. You can also go to Select, Similar, to select similar colors through the entire layer. Fashion designers use Magic Wand tool a lot. Let's go back to the option bar and explore additional settings. Anti-Alias is responsible for creating the selection smoother by grabbing neighboring pixels. However, if you want your selection to be precise, you should leave this option unchecked. Contiguous is a very powerful option. It allows you to select a color only in the neighboring area, or if left unchecked, it will select similar color through the entire layer. Right below the selection tools is a crop tool, and it does just that. It crops your document. Click and drag around the area you want to preserve. Roll cursor over to the selection to move it. You can change the selection by dragging the sides and corners and hold Shift key to preserve the ratio. Go back to the crop tool and click on it whenever you're ready to apply your changes. Click crop if you want to apply the changes. Cancel to go back and to make more changes, or don't crop to go back to your original image.